Hey guys, it's Suresh. Welcome back to my channel. Thank you so much for tuning into another video with me today. All month long, I have been reviewing a gorgeous collection of dolls from the Integrity Toys Convention Collection, which took place in November of last year. Today, I'm keeping with the Integrity Toys theme, but we're gonna take a look at a doll from the Fashion Royalty Collection for 2018. The collection was called the Sacred Lotus Collection, and oh my goodness, when I saw it, I was so excited because there were like South Asian vibes going through the whole thing. And obviously being a South Asian myself, I was really, really excited because I feel like South Asian people and brown people in general are like having a bit of a moment, you know what I mean, in pop culture, and it's about friggin' time. So today we're gonna be taking a look at the gorgeous Isha Narayanan. She is part of the Sacred Lotus Collection and she's the star of the collection. I've actually had Isha since October of last year. She's been waiting very patiently for her turn to be reviewed. I'm really, really excited to get in and see what she's all about. Right, and she comes in the beautiful Fashion Royalty box with the flap and the little twist-turn tie thingy here, which we saw debuted last year. Without further ado, let's go ahead and open up Miss Isha. Are we ready? Oh my God, I'm so excited. 1, 2, and 3. Oh my God. Oh my God, queen. Wow, you guys, she is spectacular. Okay, oh my God, let me start with this exquisite face. Wow. And look at that little nose ring. Oh my God, living. I love this beautiful white and gold dress. There are like ruffles on it. There's a very like sari-inspired fall I'm seeing. Look at that beautiful henna. Oh my goodness. Wow. And look at those gorgeous pink toenails and fingernails. I think it's pink. Wow, I'm so excited to get in and see what it's all about. Shall we go ahead and take a look at the accessories? 1, 2, and 3. Oh my God. Oh, the first thing I'm seeing are her beautiful shoes. Wow. Honey, that is a skinny stiletto. Wow. Oh my goodness. Beautiful stiletto pumps. I cannot wait to open those up and put those on her. The next thing I'm seeing are her beautiful white gloves. Gorgeous. Oh my goodness, and I'm seeing her jewelry suite here. Oh my God, look at all this jewelry. Wow, so I'm first seeing her two big chandelier earrings, and then I'm seeing her little tika, which is the jewelry that goes on her head. Gorgeous, and then I see a whole suite of bangles here. Oh my God, how beautiful. Some have stones on them, and then I see a big statement ring in a clear stone. Exquisite. And then I see her gorgeous little clutch purse here that also has some gold jewelry on it. I believe perhaps like a carrying strap. Obsessed. Last but not least, I see her carrying hands here. This is before we saw the introduction of the new elongated fingers, but obsessed. Beautiful. Okay, time to get Miss Isha out of here. I'm like, she pulls out of her carton just like so. And ta-da! So here we are, back to the gorgeous, clear, heavy acrylic stands that I love. The stand has a beautiful rose gold FR printed on it, and it goes right in here just like so. That's where it's stored. The telescoping portion of her stand is right here on the inside of the box. She's tied down with beautiful rose gold silk ribbons here. Love that. This is all that rose gold inner packaging that we saw last year. Beautiful. I mean, it does like definitely I feel like influenced the way the doll looks. So that's a little bit interesting that they chose that color. Anyway, underneath that, we see her gorgeous certificate of authenticity here. Beautiful. 1, 2, 3. Oh my goodness. Look at all this hair. Wow. So she has a big hairnet on to protect all this hair. Wow, that's a long ponytail. Love that. I did actually have a chat with Jesse last year when these girls came out, and I asked him if there was any specific actress that he was referencing for this doll, because to me she looks a lot like this gorgeous Indian actress named Deepika Padukone. And he actually told me that he was thinking a lot about Aishwarya Rai, specifically when she was young, which I can obviously see as well. And I think her coloring and her eye color kind of pay homage to that. Oh, look at the little sari fall. Oh, cute. Here is Miss Isha Narayanan, fully dressed in all of her accessories. And wow, you guys, I knew I was going to love her, but oh my goodness, in all her jewelry, she is just, I feel like this is the doll that I always dreamed of as a little South Asian kid. Look at all of her jewelry with the henna tattoo. Wow, there's like 5 bangles on each of her hands, that gorgeous ring, and check out that beautiful purse. She can like hold it, and then the little purse strap acts like a little bracelet almost. Oh my goodness. I love this beautiful gold polka dot tulle. I love the ruffle detail. Check out the shoes, honey. Beautiful gold pumps with a see-through front here. I just love that. How cool. Her head jewelry is a little bit tricky to get on, but I ended up pinning it in place with dressmaker pins there, and I actually ended up pinning the fall to kind of cover up her hair. When I take out the pin, there comes the fall down just like so, and there she is with the sari fall just kind of wrapped around. There's a little jump ring that connected all of the backs here, and I ended up taking them off because I just didn't like the way it sat. So I decided to create it myself. But right, a gorgeous, gorgeous doll. Here she is from the back. Her hair definitely needs a day at the hair spa. It is gluey and sticky and just kind of smashed into place there. There's the back there. Beautiful, right? That gorgeous ruffle detail that kind of drapes down there in the back. Exquisite. Love, love, love. I'm gonna go ahead and take just the tika off of her head. So when I first saw this, I actually thought it was two-piece because a true sari is actually two-piece. But then what I was realizing was that Jesse took inspiration from a number of other places as well. A lot of people online have referenced a lot of his collection to a Jean-Paul Gaultier couture collection. And yes, I definitely see the resemblance there. As we know, you know, Jesse and a lot of other doll designers love taking inspiration from the runways and giving us like doll-sized versions of it. And I am not mad about that because let's be honest, Jean-Paul Gaultier is amazing. And why would we not want something of his in our doll closet? Do you know what I mean? I'm actually gonna go ahead and take Isha's arm off here. That'll just make it easier to get this side off. I don't want to risk tearing or ripping any of this beautiful fabric here. Eek, ta-da! There you go. For you guys who are not Integrity collectors, that's one of the main reasons why I love Integrity so much. You can dress them and undress them so easily, and they're basically like store mannequins. Here is the gorgeous Divinity Isha Kalpana Narayanan undressed so that you guys can get a better look at her fabulous FR physique. I did leave some of her jewelry on as always. Let's just start with her exquisite face. Now, the Isha sculpt I know has been shared across a few other dolls. I believe this character went away and then another character came and kind of took over her place, but she was turned into a white character, so I think that's kind of odd and interesting. All the same, she has beautiful, really big, elongated features. Love her eyes, oh my goodness. We see a gorgeous kind of silvery white tucked there into her eyelid. We see a beautiful cut crease there, and she has applied lashes on as well. Look at that ferocious cat eye, honey. Oh my goodness, Bollywood realness. And then big, big, big pouty lips. She has a beautiful little nose ring there, which I find so, so beautiful. Love. Just the scale of it is so perfect for her, right? Her earrings are just magnificent. Lots and lots of sparkly stones on a gold backing there. I also just love the way they kind of dangle. Beautiful dark brown chocolatey colored hair tied into a ponytail here in the back, and then the front is parted in the center to make way for her tika slash head jewelry. And then there's a long ponytail that goes down past her bum. Definitely needs to be washed and restyled. So I know that many of you guys have asked me to show you how I restyle my FR dolls' hair. So stay tuned for that. I'm gonna make sure that I try and film that when I do. She has beautiful henna tattoos on her arms here, coming from her forearm down into her fingers. Look at that detail, you guys. It's like on her fingers, meeting up with her beautiful manicure there. There is her gorgeous ring in a white clear stone. Love, love. And those are all of her bangles. Just a stack of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 on her left hand, and then 5 on her right hand here. just exquisite, right? And then she has a matching pedicure here as well. Gorgeousimo, classic fashion royalty number 6 body, I believe it is, with articulation here at her shoulder, here at her elbow, and then of course she has interchangeable hands, so her hands clip on and off, which is how we get these beautiful bangles on. Of course her head moves up, down, side to side. She moves underneath her breastplate here as well. She does not move here at her waist, but then she does kick out her legs. They bend just like so, and then they move outward as well. Beautiful range of motion. Their posability, you guys, is just so fantastic. As many of you know, I have become a convert to articulated fashion royalty / IT doll. So yeah, love them. Here is her beautiful dress. Just such an interesting piece. The main layer is a really gorgeous, kind of a soft white organza that is embroidered with a beautiful kind of flower pattern, perhaps meant to look like a lotus, kind of looks like a vine. And then that goes up kind of in a tube skirt all the way up to her waist. And then we see a little bodice portion here as well. And then on top of that, we see a beautiful overlay of this white tulle that has a beautiful gold pin dot on it. So that is gorgeous. Pin dot because it's a tiny, tiny little dot versus, you know, a traditional polka dot. And then we see beautiful ruffle detail here, kind of lining that whole panel. Just gorgeous. And then we also see that same tulle gathered here at the bodice, and then the fall is attached at the waist and just kind of throws over her shoulder just like so. It's a nice long piece of tulle for the fall that she can wrap around her arm or put over her head there, as we saw earlier. Just a really beautiful piece. And then of course the whole thing is fully lined when we look inside. Beautiful. Lots of sheer lining fabrics to kind of keep that illusion alive, which I love. The openings are right back here. We see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 silver hooks, and then 5 thread loops here on the other side. Just exquisite craftsmanship here. We see all the little panels coming together to make this beautiful little bodice. We see 2 little darts here on the side. And then scrolling down, we see how beautifully the hem is finished there. Just exquisite. And then right there at her hips, we see her IT tag. Here are beautiful little gold pumps. What an exquisite shoe, huh? I absolutely love this. The back portion of the shoe is in this gorgeous soft gold faux leather fabric. And then the heel and sole portion are in a gold plastic. We see that the outsole of the shoe here is painted in that gorgeous glossy cream to give it a luxe look. And then we see the front portion, the toe box here, in a clear plastic. Here is her gorgeous little clutch purse. It is in a soft gold, kind of a matte metallic faux leather fabric here, a very traditional fold over clutch. And I absolutely love this gold handle detail here. There are some dangling little clear stones from it. It gives a look of her wearing like finger jewelry or a bracelet. Absolutely love that. And then of course, in true integrity fashion, it opens just like so. And it's a tight fit, but it does open there as well. And then on the inside here, we see the same faux leather fabric that is making up the inside of the top flap there. And then we see the big, beautiful magnet that is keeping it all shut. Here is her sweet little belt. It's the same silhouette and style of buckle that we saw in Afterglow Lilith Blair, who was a convention doll, that beautiful kind of Versace-esque stamp there at the buckle. There are little holes here as well for the buckle tooth to fall into, which makes it a functioning belt. So there we have it, guys. This is the gorgeous Isha Narayanan from the 2018 Sacred Lotus Collection for Fashion Royalty. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. I hope that you learned something. Please be sure to give it a big thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe. Make sure to hit that little bell icon after the subscribe button. That way you guys are notified every Thursday when I upload a new video. Follow me on Instagram. I'm at SureshNY. That's generally where I post all my updates. Until I see you guys again, Isha and I are headed downtown to the Paramount Theater in downtown Seattle. There is a fabulous Bollywood dance happening there and we are so excited to dance night away. Wherever you guys are in the world, I hope you're having a fantastic day. Big hugs and kisses from me and Isha here in Seattle. Mwah. And I'll see you guys again next Thursday for another video, okay? Bye!